Right now, I'm going to show you how to create a repeating kaleidoscope effect inside of Photoshop. So we're going to start with a white background and some kind of line art over the top of it. The first step is hit Control or Command T, goes into free transform mode. And now we want to set the pivot point. Now you might find the pivot point is missing, and that's because a couple of versions ago in Photoshop, it's off by default. And if you go into the options bar, we can click there, we can turn on our pivot point, and now we can drag it into position. Now here's a tip. If you hold down the Alt or the Option key, you can move that to where your cursor is. So we're going to use this as the pivot point. That means that when we rotate, it's going to rotate around this point. So let's do that right now. Let's just rotate it a little bit. And now we're going to hit the Enter key. All right, the rest of this is super simple. It's just one keyboard shortcut. Hold down Shift Option Command on Mac. That's Shift Alt Control on Windows. And with those three down, just hit the T key. And don't let go. Just tap the T key again and just keep tapping it each time. And as we do, it's going to duplicate it and add another one. All right, let's colorize this. So grab the bottom layer, not the background, but the bottom layer. Scroll up to the top. Hold down the Shift key and click on the top one. That selects all the layers in between. Control G will put it into a group. Now let's add a color over the top. The best way to do this is with a gradient fill. So let's grab our adjustment layers and we're going to use gradient. And with the gradient selected, let's change this from a linear to a radial gradient. And let's choose a more interesting color. All right, let's grab this rainbow colored gradient. And I'm just going to click OK for now. And what we're going to do is clip this inside there. So if I hold the Alt or the Option key and I click in between, it's going to clip that gradient so it just fits within the group. It's not bad, but we can make this better. So let's double click on the gradient, brings up the gradient fill, and let's change the scale. And I think that looks better. And if you want, you can grab the group and put a drop shadow on it if you want to just kind of enhance it a little bit more. So hopefully you learned something new this week. Let me know in the comments if you did. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And if you don't know where that is, it's on the YouTube page. So until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.